Rahim, today we derived Marshallian demand curve. Marshallian demand curve is function of prices and income, where income is assumed to be constant. So demand Marshallian is function of x, where x is the function of price of x and price of y, and commodity y, which is also function of price of x and price of y. So this is Marshallian demand curve. Marshallian demand curve is also called uncompensated demand curve. So today we derive it mathematically, and mathematically we have two functions. First function is called objective function, in which we maximize the objective function, as our objective is to maximize utility. So utility is function of x and y. We may write it in specific form as x, y, which is the quadratic form of equation. And second function is constraint function. Income is given, so price of x, which is also given, into x plus py into y. Here px is price of x, which is determined in the market, and x is the unit of commodity x. Similarly, py is the price of commodity y, which is determined in the market, so it is given, and y the units of commodity or service y. So for optimization purpose, here we use constraint optimization technique. In this technique, we turn these two functions into a composite function and call that the lambda, which is equal to xy minus, we may write it as plus lambda. Lambda is Lagrangian multiplier. It acts as link variable. I minus px, x minus py, y. For optimization, we take first order partial derivative with respect to one variable x and second variable y, and setting it to zero. So this is the first condition for optimization. So taking partial derivative with respect to x and setting it to zero. We get curly Lagrangian divided by x equal to, so derivative of partial derivative of x is equal to 1, and we are left with y minus, because lambda into I, which is income, so the partial derivative is 0. Here the derivative of x is 1, and we are left with lambda px equal to 0. Similarly, differentiating this composite function with respect to y, we get x minus lambda py equal to 0. and then as we have three choice variable x, y and lambda, differentiating with respect to lambda we get, so derivative of this term is equal to zero, and here the as we are deriving with respect to lambda, so derivative of this lambda is equal to 1. So we have then I minus px x minus py y equal to 0, which is equation number 3. Solving equation 1 and 2, we get y minus lambda px equal to 0, y x minus lambda py equal to 0, which can be written as y equal to lambda px and x is equal to lambda py. Here lambda is equal to y divided by px, and here lambda is equal to x divided by py. So both right hand terms are equal to lambda,